Hi, my name is David Allen with Neo4j, and this video today is going to be about how to launch a Neo4j Enterprise Causal Cluster on Google's Cloud. So right here on my desktop, I have a Google Cloud Platform project. Many of you who use this are going to be using Compute Engine for various things. Now, Neo4j has offered Causal Cluster via the Cloud Launcher. So if we go over here on the left-hand side and we click on Cloud Launcher right there, this takes us to Google's marketplace of launchable solutions. We're going to type in Neo4j and take the very first item here, Neo4j Enterprise. So this right here is where you can launch it. In a separate video, we may cover how to do a free test drive. This is also an option, but today we're going to focus on launching the Causal Cluster. The cost for launching this is basically tied to the hardware that you plan to use. The license fee for Neo4j is not built into this. It's a bring-your-own license arrangement. So if you're an existing enterprise user, or you have a trial license through Neo4j, or maybe you're a part of our startup program, then you're eligible to use this. So basically, we're just going to click here on Launch Compute Engine and fill out a simple form. So let's call my cluster Graphs Are Everywhere. It's important to pick a good name here because in your administration console, this is how everything will show up and you'll be able to tell what it is that you did. You can pick what kind of hardware you would like and what kind of zone that you would like. I'm going to stick with 4 vCPUs and 15 gigabytes of memory per machine. I'd like to have, let's say, 3 nodes in my causal cluster. These are the core nodes in Neo4j's architecture. You can also choose to add read replicas if you would like to scale out the readability of your cluster. Down in the boot disk options, I'm just going to keep this at 10 gigabytes per node, but you can adjust this however you wish. And if your project has the kind of setup where you'd like to launch it into a VPC or into a special networking configuration, you can do that there at the bottom. So once we've got our parameters just the way that we like them, we just click deploy. Now, this is going to take a minute to get ready, so let me kind of try to explain what's happening here in the background. This is using a technology called Google's Deployment Manager. And in order to deploy a causal cluster, we're going to basically create 3 of those core nodes, which you can see here as VM instances being created right now. And we're also going to need to generate a strong password to make sure that the cluster is protected. And finally, we're going to need to do some configuration to make sure that firewalling rules are in place to allow communication with that cluster from the outside. And so Google Deployment Manager does a really great job of showing us the status of all of these deploys. And so you can see that we're going to be creating a firewall rule for Bolt and so on. Now finally, there is this startup waiter. And what that startup waiter does is that when we install Neo4j on these 3 machines and get things running, we're waiting for the service to come up, for Neo4j to be running, and for the cluster to have fully formed before the cluster deployment finishes. While this is going on, you're going to see pending over here. Okay, now our deployment has completed, and the way that you'll know that it's complete is that you get the green check mark here, and over here on the right hand side, this information is now filled out. There is an entry point VM, that's just the first VM in the cluster, and there is a URL where you can access the cluster, as well as a username and a random password that is assigned. So let's give this a try and see if it worked. I'm going to copy that URL. Now, when you first deploy a cluster, of course you don't have a valid SSL certificate, so you may see a browser warning like this that says that the certificate is invalid. You can just prompt your browser to accept that certificate and go through, and later configure a certificate for your organization if you wish. We then get the standard login screen. Now I'm going to need to go back here and grab my password. And now I'm going to type in Neo4j as the username, the password is the password I was given by Deployment Manager, I connect, and I'm in. Let's quickly make sure that this cluster is okay, and let's say call dbms.cluster.overview. And it shows us that we have 3 nodes in our cluster, we have a leader, and we have 2 followers. So looks like that cluster formed well. And as you would probably expect, the cluster starts off completely empty. Now from here, you can connect any existing Neo4j tooling to this instance. So for example, you can use Cypher Shell from your desktop. You can create a remote instance from Neo4j desktop to point to this so that you can use browser and other graph apps from there to connect to this cloud instance, really whatever you like. Now, so that covers kind of getting the database set up. I want to show you a couple of quick management aspects of this. So when you do this deployment manager deploy and you launch it via Marketplace, we can then go back over to Compute Engine, and you'll see that your cluster is really just three VMs that are deployed within your project, and they can be managed and dealt with just like any existing VMs. They also will have attached disks, which you can find, and all of the other associated resources that you would normally expect. If we wanted to access one of these VMs by SSH, you can use the typical commands, gcloud compute SSH, and then the name of the VM. You just hit enter, and you're going to SSH into this VM, and it is a pretty typical Ubuntu VM. So if I do sudo systemctl status neo4j, you will see that the neo4j service is running on that machine. So that's how to access this. Now, in most cases, the configuration that's going to come with these causal clusters is going to just work out of the box. Now, your organization may have additional needs to configure LDAP plugins. You might want to install APOC into these machines. You might want to do any number of other things. And for that reason, it's really important and useful that at the end of the day, they are really just vanilla VMs running on top of Compute Engine. All right, so finally, I want to show you one last quick bit. Suppose we are finished with our cluster. We simply go back to Deployment Engine, Deployment Manager, rather, click on Deployments, and we will see that there is a Graphs Are Everywhere deployment. This corresponds exactly to what we deployed via Cloud Launcher, so we'll just click that and hit Delete. So once we hit Delete, it'll spin there for a few minutes while Google tears down all of the infrastructure and configuration that was necessary for this and gets you right back to where you were before. Basically is a good clean starting point. So now we're back to where we started. The VMs are gone and the deployment has been removed because we deleted it. If we go over here to disks, you will see that the three disks that back the VMs are still present. We did that on purpose to make it very difficult to accidentally delete the data behind your causal cluster. So if you're finished with the deployment and you want to get rid of it, you're going to want to take that extra step and go in and delete the disks manually to make sure that you don't have to continue to carry the storage costs associated with that cluster. And that's about it. We've tried to make it as easy as possible to launch a causal cluster with a known good configuration and to keep it in a situation where you retain full control over the cluster. We would love to hear your thoughts and feedback about this. Please join us on our Neo4j user Slack or tweet to Neo4j. We'd love to hear what you have to think about it.